My name is Paul Kellstedt, and I teach political science at Texas A&M University in College Station, Texas. My substantive areas of research are political behavior and public opinion, and it meshes with my methodological interests, which are time series analysis, and that's the class that I'm teaching here in the ICPSR summer program, Advanced Time Series Analysis.
My name is Mark Pickup. I teach at Simon Fraser University in Vancouver, BC, Canada. And my work primarily involves methodologically longitudinal data analysis, time series, panel data, longitudinal network analysis. Substantively, it involves things in the area of political psychology, political sociology, basically how individuals make decisions when they have to make a voting decision. Time series two is meant for individuals who've taken time series one, and it continues from time series one by discussing in the first half issues around error correction models, fractional integration, and other sort of controversies and confusion that exists currently around single equation time series models of more advanced nature. And that would be covered primarily in the first 2 weeks. And then the second 2 weeks, we move on to multiple endogenous variable time series models, so vector autoregression models, vector error correction models, and models of that sort, and then moving on to examining how classic time series models can be put in state-space form, and then some of the benefits you get from doing so, such as being able to model latent time series processes, filtering out noise from measurement error, forecasting, and that sort of, you know, time series type benefits.
The goals that we have for our class are several. The first is to make sure that we're exposing students to the very best stuff that's going on in time series analysis across the world, not just in the disciplines of political science, but all across the social sciences. And so the goal is to try to inspire people with the substantive projects that they have and to see how these different techniques might apply to their work that they're doing on, for example, their dissertations or on papers that they're doing. And we've seen a lot of success with that in the past, where students have used and adopted a technique that we've introduced to them in dissertation chapters. Indeed, there are forthcoming publications from former students in our class, and of course, we're very proud of things like that. All of our sessions involve hands-on work with a variety of statistical software, usually Stata or R, and so we come with templates of code and data that's either from our own work or replication data sets to show how the techniques that we're using and showing in theory work later on in practice in the lab. And so sometimes that actually happens in the classroom where we call up a stats program, but more often that happens in the homework assignments, and they work with our expert teaching assistants to sort of adapt and implement the things that we're using. And then their homeworks really revolve around interpreting and trying to see what sorts of techniques are working well and aren't working particularly well.